The stage is set for a governor's race for the record books. Two businessmen, Ned Lamont and Bob Stefanowski, will face off. It was a night of comebacks and history. We'll be joined by Johanna Hayes, whose upset made national headlines, and Susan Bysiewicz, once one of the state's most popular politicians, is back with a big win. Our flashback will take you to primary night 24 years ago, the last time there was a race to replace an unpopular governor. It's all straight ahead this Sunday, August 19, 2018.
From Eyewitness News, Connecticut's most watched local political program, this is Face the State.
Good morning and thanks for joining us today. I'm Dennis House. I know you just voted, but only 79 days until you do it again on Election Day. 2 months and 2.5 weeks. That's it. The field for governor looks like this. Bob Stefanowski and his running mate Joe Markley, the big winners for the Republicans. Ned Lamont and Susan Bysiewicz in a landslide for the Democrats. Independents Oz Griebel and Monty Frank are expected to make the ballot. And with us today is half of the Democratic ticket. Susan Bysiewicz, candidate for lieutenant governor, former secretary of the state. We should note that Ned Lamont could not be with us today, and Bob Stefanowski and Joe Markley were also unavailable. Madam Secretary, good to see you here on the program.
Thanks for having me. It's nice to be here.
And first, let's talk about the emotional aspect of Tuesday night. This was a long time coming since you last had a victory. How did it feel?
It felt great. We had been out doing a lot of grassroots campaigning, door knocking, phone calling. You know, we felt pretty good going into primary day. You never know. And we worked hard to get our vote out. You know, Ned Lamont and the team felt confident, and we were so pleased that both of us won.
Mr. Lamont talks about this team, and he says that you'll be sort of handling some of the government things, and he'll be doing some of the other things. What kind of teamwork, if you're elected, do you imagine seeing?
We're going to have a very collaborative approach. And I'll say that we're so proud of the very diverse ticket that won. We're very happy that Sean Wooden is the candidate for treasurer and William Tong is the candidate for attorney general. And Ned and I are going to work together to get our economy back on track and also to resolve some of these huge fiscal issues that are facing our state. And I think we are a good team because he brings his almost three decades of growing his business and working with business, and I bring both government and private sector business experience. So we're looking forward to working well together.
By government things, I meant the government minutiae, which obviously you do a lot of as Secretary of the State. You know,
yes, indeed.
The Republicans are already saying that the Lamont-Bysiewicz team is nothing more than a third term of Dan Malloy. How do you respond to that?
Well, first, I would say that neither of us were part of that administration. We didn't serve a day with him. And further, Ned actually ran against Dan Malloy for governor. So really, though, what the Connecticut voters don't want is they don't want to hear about politics. What they want to hear is, what are the solutions? What do we need to do to move our state forward? And they want to know what our plans are. So Ned and I are going to be out talking about how we're going to help small businesses, we're going to invest in infrastructure, we're going to create a pipeline from school to work, support pay equity. All of those things are critical to moving our economy forward.
How have you and Mr. Lamont settled your differences on policies? Because you do agree, you have disagreed in the past on some things.
You know, actually, one of the reasons we ran together was we didn't have any major policy disagreements, and we decided we would be stronger as a team. I mean, I really can't think of one policy disagreement that we have.
What happens if, and as you know, Lieutenant Governor Nancy Wyman had to do some tie-breaking votes, what if you're in that position and you disagree with what a Governor Lamont wants to do?
Well, first of all, we are working really hard to make sure that we don't have that 18-18 split, Republican to Democrat. I think we have some tremendous opportunities to pick up more Democratic seats in the state Senate and also in the state House, and we're so pleased to see some wonderful Democratic candidates. But I think that we are consensus builders. We work in a very collaborative way, and we're also friends, and I know that we will not be on different pages. We'll be on the same page.
I want to talk about some of the issues that will likely come up in this campaign, and one of them is, of course, jobs. People are moving out of Connecticut. What exactly is the Lamont-Bysiewicz plan to keep people in the state? Because they say it's too expensive.
Well, we're going to keep doing what we've been doing. I'll give you an example. Ned brought emphasis out of state into our state by using his network of business contacts. And what I've been doing over the past 6 years is helping more than 80 Connecticut small businesses grow and create jobs. And I've actually helped companies that were thinking about leaving the state get access to capital so that they could buy more manufacturing equipment and hire more people and stay here. So I think together we have the resources and the commitment to help keep good companies in our state and grow them.
As we look at some of the numbers from Tuesday night, of course, independents did not vote, the unaffiliated,
That's
but they'll
right.
be voting this fall. And one of the big issues on the Republican side, obviously it worked for Bob Stefanowski. He's promising to get rid of the income tax. Mark Boughton finished a strong number two, and he also promised to get rid of the income tax. Democrats aren't talking like that. Are there any taxes that you can tell the voters today and the viewers today that might be reduced?
Well, I'll say this first about both of them. Mark Boughton originally started campaigning on eliminating the income tax, and then in the days coming up to the primary, walked that back. I will say this. I think what is key for our state is not to tax more. We can't get out of the fiscal mess that we're in by taxing more, and it's getting very difficult to cut as well. We have to focus on growing our economy, and we're going to do that in some of the ways that I've talked about, investing in infrastructure, making sure that our employers have the talent and the trained young people that they need to continue to stay here. Because, you know, both GE and Aetna mentioned that they wanted to leave because they didn't feel they had the IT talent that they needed right here.
Can you rule out tax increases?
I will tell you that we are not thinking about increasing taxes. I'll defer to Ned, and you can have him back to talk about that. But our focus is on growing the economy. That's really key, and getting our fiscal house in order, because we have tremendous unfunded liabilities that we're going to have to straighten out as well.
As you know, unemployment is down. The economy seems to be humming along mm-hmm. a little bit more.
Yep.
Who gets credit for that, President Trump or Governor Malloy?
Look, half of the people in our state work for small businesses. So the people who get credit for those jobs, most of those jobs have come from small businesses that have owners who live here and families who are here. They're committed to Connecticut, and they've been growing the lion's share of the jobs. I'll also say we have some great employers like Electric Boat and UTC, and they have been growing jobs, especially EB. And the way we've been helping them to grow those jobs is by working in partnership, making sure they have the young people who are graduating with advanced manufacturing degrees and technical skills like welding.
Is campaigning against Donald Trump, though, smart policy? Because it's tricky. There are many people in Connecticut who think he's doing a good job. In fact, his approval rating in Connecticut is higher than Governor Malloy's right now. And there are some parts of the state who say, well, my 401k is up and unemployment's down.
Right.
To attack Donald Trump, could that backfire?
You know, I think the focus should be on what the candidates want to do to get our state back on track, because that's what the people of Connecticut really care about. They know that we're at a crossroads. We haven't been creating the jobs that other states around us have, and they just want to know how we're going to get back on track. And our campaign is going to focus on the very specific steps that we're going to take to do that.
It has been a long time. In fact, I think it's the 1920s. I'd have to go back and look at it. If we have any historians watching, please tweet me right now or send me a Facebook message. It's been, I think, since the 1920s, since someone from a party has replaced another person from a party. For instance, a Democrat replacing a Democratic governor in an election. How do you hope to do that? Because many people say it's a Republican year.
Look, I'll say this. What's interesting about the Republican ticket that came out of Tuesday's primary is that it is probably the most extreme and conservative ticket that we've ever had in the state. And what I'll say about the Democratic Party in Connecticut is that we are very grassroots oriented. We know how to win. And Dan Malloy won re-election by 26,000 votes. So I think if we focus on how to fix Connecticut, I think the voters will respond in a supportive way.
If you're the tie-breaking vote in the Senate to legalize marijuana, would you do it?
Yes.
Tolls?
I'll say this. We are at the bottom 10 in infrastructure in our state. And Ned and I want to put us in the top 10. And if it takes putting tolls on commercial trucks, large commercial trucks, we'll look at it, like Rhode Island's doing, and it's working well.
Susan Bysiewicz, the Democratic nominee for lieutenant governor. We thank you for being on the program
today. Thanks for having me.
We'll see you again. When we come back, Johanna Hayes and her history-making victory. And we welcome you to watch past interviews of Face the State on our website, WFSB.com, the Channel 3 app, or on our new YouTube channel.